late Victorian London lived many detectives who were the rivals of Sherlock Holmes.
Inspected the corpse. What else is there worthy of particular note? Consider the evident characteristics of the dead man. Youngish, personable, smartly dressed, something of a dandy. One suspects a ladies' man with a good deal of male vanity. And yet there is one outstanding characteristic. Are you with me yet? Return to your seats, gentlemen, and brood on the fact that you have failed to notice that the middle waistcoat buttons are done up in the wrong holes.
Thank you, Dr. Jarvis. You may breathe again.
Thank you.
And now, you happy few who have survived to the end of this course of lectures, be so good as to prove that you have learned something by turning out your pockets of those articles which every eager student of medical jurisprudence should carry about his person. No. Must I begin all over again? Pocket knife. Pocket thermometer. Magnifying lens. Scalpel. Forceps. Small box containing slides, cover slips, molding wax.
Dr. Thorndyke. Excuse me, sir.
Heart. Have you come back for a refresher?
No, sir. I've just been sent for to a case. Would you come with me, sir?
Why?
It's just around the corner, only 5 minutes away, and it is my first.
Aha. Are you in practice here now?
No, assistant to the police surgeon.
Ah.
He must be out. They found me here. I'd be terribly grateful if you could.
Dr. Hart, you are fully qualified.
It is a case of murder, sir.
Dead cart waiting, bell clanging.
You're the police, Doctor?
I am.
She's upstairs. Come on, Phil.
Nothing had happened till half an hour ago. I swear I didn't. I thought she'd gone to work like she always did. And then I went out in the backyard and saw her blind, mister. I went upstairs and knocked at the door. She didn't give no answer. I knocked again. She still didn't answer. So I wondered if she'd got something in that over there. And then I went in. I wouldn't go in that room again. Not if you paid me all the money in the world.
Out.
I'll be out here if you want me.
Thank you, Mrs.
Goldstein. Mrs. Goldstein.
Well, Hart, what are you waiting for?
For you, Dr. Thorndyke.
I am here only to see that you do credit to my teaching.
Good God. Some infernal, cowardly beast has done this. He shall hang. By God, he shall hang.
That's what we're here for, Hart.
I'm sorry, sir,
restrain
but I could not
your
help.
Emotion. Get out your notebook and take notes in the manner I've taught you.
Yes, sir.
Jarvis, you can be useful. I want a plan of the room with a detailed description of everything in it.
Certainly, Dr. Thorndyke.
Anything else?
Not at the moment.
The key?
Get on with your work. The foolish bloodhounds will be here any minute, trampling and rummaging. Mrs. Goldstein.
I'm not going in there again.
Did she always lock her door at night?
Yes. Yes, I think so. The key was always inside.
But it was unlocked this morning.
Yes, I just opened the door and went straight in.
And the street door, was that secure when you came down this morning?
It was locked.
But not bolted?
We never bolt the door. Some of the lodgers comes in late sometimes.
I understand exactly what you mean. Well, whom are we going to hang?
She was stabbed in the neck.
Evidently.
With a knife.
We assume.
Very forcibly, by someone with considerable strength.
Good point.
But someone of short stature.
No, why?
The box over there with the hassock on it. The murderer could not reach her from the side of the bed and was not tall enough to lean over the bed head. So he put those there to stand on.
Ah, yes, I see. Thank you. What else?
Nothing else yet.
The pillow?
I beg your pardon, sir.
What do you make of this?
Sand.
Sand? Where?
Silver sand on the pillow.
What do you make of that, revered sir? We will consider the explanation later. Dr. Hart, would you do me the kindness of drawing back the bedclothes?
I should tell you, one basin full of blood-stained water.
Murderers commonly wash their hands.
Sir, look. Come and look.
Look at what?
I was wrong. It was done by a woman.
Yes. Would you, gently as possible, separate the fingers?
I can't, sir. Rigor mortis.
Yes.
But that is definitely a woman's hair.
Yes, have you taken her temperature?
No, not yet.
Do so.
You would agree, would you not, sir, that that is definitely a woman's hair?
I would agree that there is more here than meets the eye at first glance.
Three books, all romances, all in German.
The book on the bedside table?
Also German.
And the candlestick?
It's burnt right down, just a tiny bit at the bottom of the socket.
Make a particular note of the pattern of that socket.
I'm afraid the foolish bloodhounds are arriving.
We've done something. Not enough, but something.